need somebody like me.
This is the fundamental analysis of GMA 7 ending third quarter of 2022. Tignan natin kung ano yung nagbago sa fundamentals ng company and saan siya magandang bilhin that can give us at least 10% year on year for the next few years. So GMA 7, part yan ng mid-cap index, part din siya ng dividend yield index and malas yan magbigay ng dividends the past years and including this year. Pero there's an interview lately kung saan sinabi na mag-expect ka daw ng lower dividends by siguro next year. May mga nag-cut back ng ads tulad nila Nestle, Unilever, and Unilab. And eto guys, hindi siya issue lang ni GMA7. In fact, global issue yan right now. Kasi nga, usap-usapan yung recession, high interest rate, inflation, things like that. Madaming advertisers ang nag-cut back ng kanilang ads. And makikita mo yan sa earnings report ng Google and Facebook or Meta kung saan they registered lower revenues in terms of their ad. And ma-observe din yan ng mga YouTuber. So yung ad revenue nila this year is lower compared sa ad revenue nila last year. And here's the growth overview for GMA7. Revenues, net income, cash flows still going up. Pero if you look at the trailing 12 months, mas mababa siya compared to last year in terms of income and cash flows. And again, ito yung isa sa mga qualities ng companies that malinis yung balance sheet nito and they don't have that much long-term and short-term obligations. And nag-generate sila ng madaming cash flows, at least for now. Okay, we'll have to find out next year. Shares outstanding is flat and debt to EBITDA napakababa kasi nga they don't have that much debt. It's an all-check company. And eto na, di ba? So, quarterly performance, revenues going down, net incomes going down. Ayan o. So, ang peak niya this year is 2 billion. Third quarter, guys, 1.1 billion na lang. And eto na, di ba? So, sinabi, ikakat nila yung dividends nila. Assuming 1 billion na lang per quarter talaga yung kanilang generate na profits and pati na rin yung cash flow nila, that's 4 billion per year. Ngayon, kung i-maintain nila yung 14.73% na dividend yield, kailangan nilang magbayad ng 5 billion. So, kukulangin yun, guys. And wala nang matitira sa nila or sa nilang cash flows kung mangyari yan. Ngayon, kung hatiin nila yung dividend yield na yan, so right now, 14.73%. So, ito yung dividend history ng GMA7. So, 14.4 to 13, then naging 14 this year. Let's say hatiin nila yan into 7% dividend yield, which is malaki pa rin yun na above average pa rin yun na dividend yield. Kung ganun yung mangyayari, ang babayaran lang nila is 2.5 billion of payout na yun, pasok na yun. Let's say 1 billion na lang talaga yung kanilang i-generate na profits and cash flows until next year, every quarter. So 2.5 billion or 7% of dividend yield at its current price. I think malay pa rin yon. Ngayon, the worst case scenario is that itong 1.1 billion na to, baka hindi pa ito yung bottom or yung adjustment ng pag-cutback ng mga big advertisers. Baka mas mababa pa sa 1 billion ang may tatala nila na quarterly performance in terms of income and cash flows. If that's the case, baka kailangan pa nilang ibaba yon. Now, let's take a look at the fair valuation of this company. So, yung company ito, nag-grow 7.7% year on year for the past 5 years. That's the case, 18.61. Pero, nakita nyo kanina that on the growth trajectory, the company is slowing down. And quarterly growth rate niya right now is 10.84. Ngayon, assuming hindi na magde-decline si GMA7 and magiging flat growth na siya moving forward, if that's the case, then 13.94. So as you can see, bumaba yung valuations ni GMA7 from second quarter to third quarter because of that na nagkakat ng advertisement budget ang mga advertisers. Kasi for as long as merong talk about recession, I think magtitipid yung mga advertisers na yan. Kasi if there's a recession, di ba, yung spending habit ng mga tao, eh, mas mababa. So if the company will grow 7.7% year on year for the next few years, 18.61. So 18.61, all-time high niya sana kung sakali. Kaso, mapupurnada ata yan kasi nga, nag-cutback ng advertisement yung mga big advertisers. So, meron siya ngayong declining growth. Na if that's the case, 10.84 na mababa siya right now. In fact, dyan siya nag-correct malapit. And then, moving forward, assuming di na sila magde-decline, flat growth na lang sila, then 13.94 or around 14. So, 14, dito pa yan, babalik yan dito. Assuming di na sila magde-decline ulit on the next few quarters. And here's my one-pager stock analysis na ipiprint ko on PDF format. And then, sinasave ko siya on Google Folder or Google Drive, accessible to all the sponsors of this channel. And for the sponsors of this channel, tick nyo lagi to guys, yung view details, then activity. And makikita nyo ano yung mga stocks na in-upload ko on these folders. And of course, you can support me as well and become part of my growing sponsors. And if you sponsor this channel, you'll get exclusive perks na basically mga investing tools na ginagamit ko to do my own stock research. And that's it. That's my analysis of GMA 7 ending third quarter. Thank you and bye-bye. Like, subscribe.